Welcome to another exciting action-packed hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Professional wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Hi, wrestling fans. I'm Bob Cole along with Dr. Dirty Dutch Mantel. A great hour in store for all our wrestling fans this week. Dutch, we got a U.S. Junior Heavyweight title match. Louis Bacoli and Chris Candido. That's going to get our program underway. Killer Kyle is going to be here. He's going to take on the Dirty White Boy. That's going to be some match. We're going to be hearing from Terry Funk. That's going to be about Sunday, Bloody Sunday, no doubt about that. And then what about Down and Dirty?
Okay, it's my special guest today, Jimmy Cornette, who has got some special words to say. Something about some legal proceedings and a court injunction. Right, my special guest today. Stay tuned and listen to it.
All right, fans, as we say, we're going to have a junior heavyweight title match, our opening bout. Let's bring in Louis Bacoli right here, newcomer to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. I understand you came all the way over here just to find and track down Chris Candido.
That's right. I came all the way from California. That loudmouth Chris Candido, he don't want to come out and give me a title shot. So I just had to come here to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and I'm not going back to California a loser. I'm going to get him right now.
All right, fans, as we say, that's our first match, and we're about ready. Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this first match on Smoky Mountain Wrestling is for the United States Junior Heavyweight title. Introducing the challenger from Anaheim, California, 229 pounds, Louis Bacoli.
Okay, Bob, let's kick it off right here. Pump up the music, the suicide squad. Chris Candido, that's his music, and he will be making his way through the ring momentarily. Now, Louis Bacoli, the man we just talked to, or you just talked to, just a few moments ago, standing in the ring, and it said that since Candido would not come to California to defend the U.S. Junior Heavyweight title, he'd have to come here, and he said that he's not leaving with that. Let's hear the ring introduction right now.
Bacoli made an impressive debut right here last week, too, Dutch.
Let's go to our official announcer, Brian Matthews.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the current United States Junior Heavyweight Champion from Asbury Park, New Jersey, 224.4 pounds, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido.
Okay, now a lot of questions that are still lingering about Chris Candido, but let's talk a little bit about Louis Bacoli. Now, you said he made an impressive debut last week. Well, he made his debut. Now, how impressive it was that he got a win.
Well, that's pretty impressive, wouldn't you say?
Well, it's all right. I mean, I'm not going to go overboard and jump into the swimming pool and do backflips, but he did make a pretty solid showing last week. Now, he's in the ring against the man that supposedly he come to Smoky Mountain to face, and it didn't take him long to get it. In the ring against the triple title holder, and that's the first in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido. Now, the next question is Tammy Fish.
Hey, wait a minute. She's in rings. What the heck is she doing out here? What's her connection with Candido?
Okay, I was going to bring that up. Now, she made it up. Ooh, does she look hot today or what? A good move by
Spicoli. Sharp.
A good move by Spicoli.
But I tell you, Prime Time Brian Lee, Chris Candido, Tammy Fitch, they've all been almost inseparable lately, Dutch.
Well, that question of why Tammy Fitch is at the ring accompanying Chris Candido, I still really haven't got an answer to it, but it's obviously some arrangement, some deal they've worked out. Wait a minute, Spicoli rolling in. He got under the leverage of Candido, almost got the pin. Going for the backslide. Candido sitting down on it.
And he's got him in a backslide.
Spicoli had the advantage. Candido calling timeout.
You know what? There ain't no timeout, Dutch. Why did he do that? You know.
Well, there should be.
It should. Hey, right now, while they're really going at it in there, you're seeing two tough competitors, man. Let me remind all you fans that the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Camp is now open to the public. And if you want to wrestle, call 615-587-1273 for more information. Hey, you might be in a championship match right here someday if you do that.
Hey, me?
No. Whoever does that. Not you or I, Dutch.
Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Divorce court. That hurts. That hurt me.
All right, Candido now. He may have him up for that superplex.
Wait a minute.
My heavens alive.
Now, when is the last time you saw a move like that in the United States?
It's been a long, long time.
Long time, because I've said this time and time again, Smoky Mountain, you got to be a tough son of a gun to hold your own in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Now, I'm not going to mention any names, but there's some other federations around that pay big money, and the wrestlers aren't one-third as good as they are here in Smoky Mountain.
Candido now with a suplex on Spicoli. And you know, Spicoli reaching around, favoring that back of his. His back is taking some punishment.
You know, another guy that's learning his mouth around here, the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers, yep. And he's had a lot of bad things to say about Chris Candido. Now, Candido's alleging that his real name is Vito Marinero of Schuylkill Haven.
Smothers says that's not true.
Well, how do you know it's not true?
Yeah, Smothers says so.
You
say they're from Scuggle Haven, Pennsylvania?
Yeah. Up there close to where that gopher, that groundhog, comes out down Groundhog's Day every year.
Have you got a tape that Candido gave you, Dutch?
Do I have a what?
Have you got a tape that Candido gave you?
Well, yeah. He didn't give it to me. He gave it to our production people, and supposedly it proves that Tracy Smothers is not from Springfield, Tennessee, but from Schuylkill, Pennsylvania. Did you hear me?
I heard you.
Okay. Now, don't sit here like I'm not even here, Bob. When
I
say something,
you.
I want a response. You know, it's called conversation.
A lot of times, Dutch, what you say sort of...
It goes over your head.
Blows me out of the chair.
Okay, okay.
I got to regroup and think about it.
Bob, don't get me started right now. Let's go back to the match right now. We see the United States Junior Heavyweight Champion, and the belt is on the line, fans, if you tuned in a little late. United States Junior Heavyweight Championship on the line in this match. Newcomer Louis Spicoli challenging the incumbent champion, Candido. Wait a minute, good move.
Oh, he caught that knee and then a good takedown and a count of two. Hey, Dutch, clothesline right there by Candido. You're seeing some good moves from two terrific athletes in that ring, in Louis Spicoli and Chris Candido.
Well, Tammy,
they've really been going after each other.
Well,
I still don't know what Tammy Fitch is doing out there.
Well, she's still there, and whatever she's doing there.
Candido, about three-fourths of the way across the ring off of that corner turnbuckle, count of two again on Spicoli.
Now, what Candido's going to have to concentrate on right now is don't make a mistake. Don't beat yourself. If the guy beats you, then let him do it. If he can do it, let him go and beat you. But don't make a mistake. And Candido is still inexperienced in a lot of ways, but he has made great, great strides in the short time he's been here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. But still, you know, it's true in football, it's true in basketball. Don't beat yourself.
Well, Dutch, the referee was checking that arm. It evidently was not a chokehold. I don't know whether he had some sort of a sleeper hold on Spicoli or not, but the referee was keeping track of it. And he said, oh, it was all right. Candido kept it, and now Spicoli turning in, trying to get turned into the Candido, okay. Almost on his feet.
Okay, our Smoky Mountain.
He's got to reverse this, Dutch.
Our Smoky Mountain Wrestling blood count is right down at ringside.
Well, that shows you some power to be able to reverse a hole like Candido had on Spicoli. He whips him to the ropes under that, but he can't duck that kick.
Well, now this may be the chance for young Louis Spicoli from Anaheim, California.
Boy, Candido went high into the air. He just splattered that mat when he hit it.
Spicoli, very stocky young man. A spinning heel kick, more prominent in Japan than it is in the United States, but now it's a lot of American guys are starting to use it.
You talk about him being stocky, but he surprises you with some of the moves he comes up with. Monkey flip coming out of the corner. Boy, he's got Candido reeling. He might finish him off right here. No! What? Tammy Fitch held him. Tammy Fitch got the arm of Candido and held him in the corner. One, two, three. Again, Tammy Fitch. Tammy Fitch interfered, Dutch. I saw her
holding. Ladies
hold
and gentlemen,
him.
Here's your winner of the match and still United States Junior Heavyweight Champion, Chris Candido.
Well, now, I don't know so much.
Watch this. Watch it, Dutch. Watch it in slow motion
now. Well, okay.
Now, look at this.
Okay, first of all.
Look at there.
What I see in this is she just wanted to hold Candido's hand. I think she's sort of sweet on Candido, and she wants to hold his hand. In either case, Candido successfully defends his United States Junior Heavyweight Championship over Louis Spicoli. Now, fans, we talked a little bit a while ago about Tracy Smothers. I want to go right now to a tape Chris Candido says proves his claims. Let's hear this from the WWA president, Dennis Coraluzzo.
This is WWA President Dennis Coraluzzo, and I'm here at the Hall of Records in Philadelphia to prove what Chris Candido has been saying all along, that Tracy Smothers is really Vito Marinara from Schuylkill Haven, PA. An associate of mine is now right in the hall at this time copying the birth certificate. He should be here very shortly. Alfonso, you keep that camera on. I paid you for the whole hour. Hey, Vinny, you got the merchandise.
Geez, man, those slacks aren't easy to pick like they used to be. Is that a camera
roll? Hey, don't worry. Here we go, people. Living proof that Tracy Smothers is really not from Tennessee, right here in black and white.
Dennis, got my fertility?
How much are you, Vinny?
$50.
$50?
$50.
You gotta be kidding, Vinny. What are you busting my chops for? I've been good to you for a long time. You're trying to fleece me. What's the deal here?
Yo, Dennis, I put my parole on the line for you. You know? Don't be a cheap Siciliano.
Oh, gee.
You know?
Hold on here, Vinny. Hey, Vinny, here. Take that.
Well, like a pawn shop?
Hey, hold. Hey, buddy, give me a favor. We got $20. You know, I'm in a jam.
Up yours. Gotta go, Dennis.
Vinny, I'll mail it to you, buddy. I'll mail it to you. Hey, officer, he went that way.
All right, fans, with us here right now at ringside, Jim Cornette. Jim, let's talk about Sunday,
yeah.
Bloody Sunday. Bloody Sunday, Sunday, Bloody Sunday in Knoxville. It's going to be blood all over the place. I think a lot of it's going to be yours.
Matt, oh, don't say that, Bob. You know, you're a very lurid individual. You're a very vulgar person. I'm going to talk about something today that I've been waiting a long time for. It's the Texas death match between the turbulent Texan Terry Funk and the Bullet, otherwise known as Bob Armstrong. It's going to take place February 13th in Knoxville, and there's a lot riding on this, and rather than me tell y'all about it right now, I want you to hear some words from the master of the Texas Deathmatch, Terry Funk. You take a listen to this right now.
The Funk family, the Funk brood, is coming to Knoxville. And I will wrestle Bob Armstrong in a Texas death match. Brother, oh brother, tell them the rules of a Texas death match.
This is your kind of match. This is a Texas death match. Falls don't count in a Texas death match. There can be 1 or 100. There's no stopping the match for any reason. Falls can take place anywhere. And number one, there is no stopping the match because of blood. So if you people can't stand blood, my suggestion is you don't look toward that ring, because Bob Armstrong's blood will be splattered all over Knoxville. It's a Texas death match. The last man standing is the winner. And it's going to be the king of the Texas death match is my brother, Terry Funk.
Why are you going to be there, brother? It's not to interfere in any match, is it?
No. I'm going to be there. Bob Armstrong remembers me from a long time ago, and I know Armstrong. And I'm going to make sure, I'm going to protect Jim Cornette. I'm going to protect Jim Cornette from all of Bob Armstrong's illegitimate relatives that might be around there.
Oh, yes, I am coming to Knoxville. And I know a lot about Knoxville. Yes, I do. On a windy day, with a wind blowing from the east, I can whiff, and I can sniff, and I can smell Knoxville all the way out here in the Panhandle of Texas. And what does it smell like? It smells like butt crack Tennessee. That's right. It smells like butt crack Tennessee. And let me tell you something. It also smells like fear. And what kind of fear does it smell like? It smells like fear. It smells like warmed over death. Oh, is it Bob Armstrong shaking under his covers, covered up, thinking the Funks are coming? Or is it Bob Armstrong standing in front of a hot fireplace? Do you understand? Warmed over death. Are you that old Armstrong? My brother and I have a date.
in Knoxville.
All right, and we just heard from Terry. What about equal time now?
What about equal time? You've been working with these politicians too long. Let me explain something right now. There is no equal time as far as Terry Funk. He's the king of the Texas Deathmatch. His father, the late, great Dory Funk Sr., invented the Texas Deathmatch, and Terry Funk has had a million of them. He knows all the ins and all the outs. And Bullet Bob Armstrong is going to be... What do you want?
I want to hear from the Bullet. The Bullet probably got something to say also.
Who cares?
You know, since I signed this contract to wrestle Terry Funk in a Texas Deathmatch, everybody's called me and said, Bullet, you made a mistake. The man's never been beaten. Well, although he beat Bob Armstrong and he had to leave Knoxville, he's not beat the Bullet yet. Texas Deathmatch or not, I know his daddy invented it, and I know Cornette, your evil mind, has put that last little clause in there that says, if I lose the match, the Bullet's gone, Bob Armstrong's gone, and you're going to run rampant in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And not only that, if I lose, I'm supposed to crawl across the ring and kiss your feet. Well, brother, I got something for you to kiss, and I ain't talking grits. I'll never do that. I'll take my last breath, like I said before, on God's green earth before I do that. So you come on down to that Civic Coliseum. I'm tired of fooling around. I've been lucky, no doubt about it. You brought in some big guns, and some way, I found a way around it, and I'm still here. I'm still fighting for Bob Armstrong's spot as commissioner. But I know I'm going to run out of body parts before your mother runs out of money. So let's get it all done in one night. Let's do it in Knoxville, and let's do it once and for all.
All right, fans, it's all going to come down February 13th in Knoxville.
Let me just say one thing to all these defective genetic morons out here. I know you love the Rock and Roll Express, and I know you love Bullet Bob Armstrong, and I know you love all these other people, but when I'm talking, I expect to be afforded a little respect. I expect for people to shut up and listen to what I've got to say. Bob Armstrong, I've waited for this for a long time, brother, and I'm going to make the most of it. Texas Deathmatch, February 13th, Knoxville. Bob Armstrong against Terry Funk, and everything's riding on it. He's put it all on the line. Roll the dice. Sure, if the Bullet beats Terry Funk, then that means that Bob Armstrong is the commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling again. I know all these idiots would love that. But if the Bullet loses, if Bob Armstrong loses to Terry Funk, then, brother, you've got to take that mask off, Bullet, and you've got to show your face this time. And you have to leave Smoky Mountain Wrestling forever, and your last official act will be to get down on your hands and your stinking knees. Yeah, that's exactly right. And crawl across that ring and kiss my smelly, two-week-old, ain't-been-washed feet, Bob Armstrong, because I can't hurt you. I can't put you out of business. I can't injure you so bad that you won't come back, because I've tried. But how do you harm a prideful man? You hit him in his pride. And all the people in Knoxville that have supported you for 25 years, all your family, all your friends, all your fans, will watch you, Bob Armstrong, kiss the feet of Jim Cornette in the middle of the Knoxville Civic Coliseum February 13th. And if you want to get out of doing that, you've got to beat Terry Funk in a Texas death match, and that's a task that can't no man come up with, no matter how bad they really are.
Ooh, fans, Sunday Bloody Sunday, February 13th in Knoxville. Don't dare miss it. We'll be back.
And Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming to Red Jacket, West Virginia, at the Red Jacket Grade School on Friday, February 18th, 8 o'clock in the gym there. Five big matches in Red Jacket, West Virginia. West Liberty, Kentucky at the Morgan County High School, Saturday, February 12th, 8 p.m. Two title bouts and a battle royal in West Liberty, Kentucky. Appalachia, Virginia, Civic Center, Friday, February 4th, 8 p.m. The Rock and Roll Express, the Dirty White Boy, and more in Appalachia. And Harlan, Kentucky, Kaywood High School, Friday, February the 11th at 8 p.m. You're going to see a U.S. Junior Heavyweight title match, Tracy Smothers against Chris Candido, a grudge tag match, the Bruise Brothers against the Moondogs, and in two out of three falls, the Smoky Mountain Tag titles on the line, the Rock and Roll Express against the Heavenly Bodies, Friday, February the 11th, Harlan, Kentucky, Kaywood High School.
You know, I heard a lot about the history of Harlan, Kentucky, what all used to go on around there, but I want to invite all you fans to come on down here to see this right here. You see, because this is a situation that happened between us and Jimmy Cornette that involved my dad. Nobody's seen it on TV. But Jimmy Cornette, I want you to know one thing. See, you and your Heavenly Bodies, you take those titles, just throw them out the window, because we don't care about them anymore, not at this time. You see, because we know that your tag team can't beat us twice in one night. but we know we can beat them twice in one night. And I know during one of those falls, Jimmy, that we're going to be able to get our hands on you. And one thing my dad always told me, he says, you know, you get that one big chance in life, it always goes around. Our one big chance is going to be right here in Harlan. Wait and see.
Harlan, Kentucky, Kaywood High School, Friday, February the 11th, 8 p.m. It's a Smoky Mountain street fight. The dirty white boy with the white girl against primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fish.
You know, I like Harlan, Kentucky because, you know, Mr. Ron Wright, he told me all about Harlan, Kentucky. He said the day that the people up there are born, they come out fighting the doctors. They love to fight up there. Well, that's right down a white boy's alley. You want a street fight? You've got it, tough guy. And what happens if Tammy Fetch gets in the way?
You know, I love street fighting. There's nothing like a little clothes coming off or a little slapping or using little fists. That's right up my alley, honey, and I'm going to tear you up.
Fans, on February 13th, the Bruise Brothers suspension will be up, and they'll face the Moondogs inside a steel cage. Now, that may be the safest place for the fans, the bystanders, or anybody else. And you'll see what we mean by that when you look at this. Let's watch it right now.
One of the Bruise Brothers has one of his wrestling boots off, ready to tee off on a Moondog. And look out there. But Mark Curtis is outside following the action there. And look out, Curtis is rammed into the ring post. Mark Curtis knocked into the ring post, and he is down outside of the ring, and the attempted pin for not there, as the Moondogs are able to take advantage of Mark Curtis being in the wrong place at the wrong time. The referee finally getting up, and now he sees, and a count of three, and the Moondogs are going to win this match here. So the Moondogs able to take advantage of the fact that Mark Curtis was knocked, not called, but certainly senseless for a little bit outside of the ring. And now the Bruise Brothers are not too happy with the Smoky Mountain wrestling official. Wait a minute. This thing is technically over. But it's not over, because now the Bruise Brothers, they may have officially lost the match, but they're not going to take the decision lying down. They're outside of the ring. All four men are outside of the ring, and this one is continuing on. Here they go back towards the dressing room area. Kevin, can we turn around here with the camera and keep going on the outside? As the Bruise Brothers and the Moondogs are now working their way backstage. And let's keep with the action here, as this thing has exploded all over the building here at Freedom Hall. The official decision, the Moondogs the winners. But these guys are continuing the action now backstage here at Freedom Hall. Mark Curtis is trying to separate the four. That's not going to work. The action continues backstage. Whoa, man! That'll rattle your cage. The Bruise Brothers are really taking it now to the Moondogs. This action, here's a big garbage can, chairs. We mentioned before about anything could wind up being in this match, and certainly it is. These four guys are going at it. They're backstage here at Freedom Hall. I think we're still on the air. I don't even know. We're going to keep with the commentary. Our camera equipment having to jockey around here to get backstage. I think Kevin's been able to get us, though, to stay on the air, so we're going to keep talking about it. The Moondogs and the Bruise Brothers, chairs, garbage cans, tables, ladders. Oh, my. This thing has exploded all over the building. All over the building. I hope the folks here at Freedom Hall have insurance for this stuff. Because, again, this is outside of the wrestling ring. This is taking place after the match was decided. And now the Moondogs getting a little activity in the back with that big stick, garbage cans, poles, pylons. Mark Curtis is literally helpless here as he is trying to put an end to this and unable to do so. This feud is far from over. The Moondogs won the match in the ring, but we're having a match and a half outside of the ring. These guys are going at it hot and heavy, the likes of which I haven't seen in quite some time in a professional wrestling environment. Again, this thing ended minutes ago in the ring, but it has exploded back in the dressing room area. Jim Cornette's got the whistle, and he's hauling the Moondogs back to the dressing room. The Bruce brothers, though, don't want to quit here.
Hey.
They are not finished here. The Bruce brothers are not finished with the Moondogs by a long shot.
It's going to be the wildest cage match of all time, fans. February 13th, Sunday, Bloody Sunday in Knoxville. Now, we'll be right back after this.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Howard Stern, and man, did I sucker you people in. My special guests are on their way to the ring right now, but till they get here, I got a special interview I'd like to show you from two guys who think they're real great. They thought they were great football players, and now they think they're great wrestlers. Doug and Mike Furness, watch this, and then we'll talk to my special guest.
Bub, take a look at this and tell me what it is.
Boy, that is the most disgusting thing I've ever seen. It looks like, you know, all the country people out there, it looks like what you use out there by the outhouse when you run out of corn cobs, and everybody knows what those are for. That looks like an Alabama cheerleader or Jim Cornette's backside. I can't remember. I just can't stand that. It's disgusting stuff. Oh, let's get on it worse than that.
You know, let me tell you something. February 13th, if you think for a minute that two players from University of Tennessee is going to wear this in the middle of the ring, there's no way.
It ain't going to happen. We're going after this thing right here, and we're going to do the right thing with it when we get there.
And that's knock some knots on some heads. And Cornette, you stick that little beanie head of yours through there, and I will put a major dent in it.
All right, my special guest here on Down and Dirty with Dutch, right now, Jim Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies. And Jim, I told the people you had a very important announcement and you'd like to tell them right now.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And before I do that, I'd like to say one thing about what we just saw, those two dumb jock mushmouth University of Tennessee volunteer football players. The Furnace is February 13th in Knoxville. It's the Tennessee-Alabama match. There's going to be a UT football helmet on top of a 10-foot pole. Whoever gets it can use it any way they want. And if the Furnaces lose, then, brother, they got to stand in the middle of the ring. You know, I love to humiliate people. Because you got an athlete, that's the worst injury that he could have is humiliation in front of his fans. The Furnaces will have to stand in the middle of the ring, and they'll have to put on University of Alabama sweatshirts. Whoa. And proclaim them the greatest college football team of all time. And we're going to beat the Furnaces, and we're going to humiliate them just like Bob Armstrong. And then, here's the announcement that the world has been waiting for. It's obvious that the Rock and Roll Express are out of their minds. It's obvious that Ricky Morton's a psychotic. It's obvious the whole family and Robert Gibson, too, are nuts. They're trying to kill me for no apparent purpose. I have gone and I have gotten an injunction. My attorneys met with the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Board of Directors, and it's basically this. They can't be coming out here disrupting television, can't be disrupting interviews. No. I've got an injunction. If the Rock and Roll Express attack me, even lay one finger on me outside a sanctioned match, then they'll both be suspended indefinitely. Out of here. They won't get their revenge.
So what you're saying, if they touch you outside a sanctioned Smoky Mountain Wrestling match, they're out of here.
That's exactly. I couldn't do anything about what happens in the course of a match, but they can't disrupt any more of our interviews. Right. They can't disrupt any more of my things that I do over there to set, and they can't attack me outside a sanctioned match between the Heavenly Bodies and the Rock and Roll Express. Now I want to say one more thing. I don't know why that Ricky Morton is so upset about his father nearly being blind in one eye or whatever's the matter with him. Because after all, I know Paul Morton. I've known him for a long time. The guy has been blind, staggering, falling down drunk for the past 25 years. He's got a drinking problem is what he's got. Yeah. He's a staggering, falling down drunk, and he's been blind for...
Wait a minute, guys. Wait a minute.
Go ahead and hit him! Hit him just one time, and then we'll be ready, Morton. Go ahead, touch him just one time. Hit him. Come on, big boy. Touch him.
Okay, it looks like Cornette is...
One time, Morton, unless it's a match between us and you. One time, and your history.
Well, fans, it looks like Cornette is begging Ricky Morton. I'm stepping back out of the way now.
You are a coward. One time, and you'll be gone, Jack.
Well, fans, it looks like Jimmy Cornette is begging Ricky Morton to come into the ring. Ricky Morton being restrained. Here he comes. Wait a minute. Here he comes again. If he touches him now, we got an injunction.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is a tag team match introducing at a total weight of 446 pounds, Jason Hurd and Jason West.
Jason Hurd and Jason West, a tag team of the Jasons. Now coming to the ring right now, a team that should be very, very hyped and very pumped to go. The Rock and Roll Express, just a few moments ago, Ricky Morton had to be restrained from the Down and Dirty.
I know Morton is. And they come in, and they come in to mean business. They just throw Hurd right out of the ring.
I can't believe how cowardly Ricky Morton is.
They're loaded for bear.
I can't believe how cowardly.
What do you mean a coward?
Oh, if he wanted
to
get
everything in his power to get the cornet.
Oh, there was nothing but air between him and the ring. He didn't want to come.
It's about the family pride. That's what it is. And that's what's going to happen when Morton gets hold of Cornet. Hey, by the way, we understand that Paul is better, Dutch. We wish him a speedy recovery.
Well,
one, two, he's not going to get up.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winners, Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, okay. Anyway, the Rock and Roll Express hot on the trail of the Heavenly Bodies. Now let's watch a little slow-mo here. The signature move of the Rock and Roll Express, and they knock one of the Jasons down. I think that's Jason Hurd, son of Jim Hurd. Anyway, they get the count here. Let's go right now to Bob Caldwell standing by with a very hot and pumped up Rock and Roll Express.
All right, fans, here they are, the Rock and Roll Express. Rick, I got to tell you, you can tell that your anger carried right over into that bout, and I think you was trying everything in your power to get to Jim Cornette.
Well, Bob, this goes up to everybody that thinks they know everything about professional wrestling. You see, this right here involved my dad. That means family. That means blood's a lot thicker than water. It means it's personal. You see, Jimmy Cornette, I don't care. You got an injunction against me, but you see, we got matches coming up with you. And we're going to walk through your heavenly bodies because I'm going to get to you. I'm going to get to you, Jimmy Cornette. I'm sick and tired of you putting down all these fans, putting down my family personally, and then touching my family. Oh, get it. There's a time and place for a thing. And Jimmy Cornette, bet your ass on it, brother. I'm going to get to you.
The biggest wrestling card in the history of Knoxville takes place at the Coliseum on Sunday, February 13th at 3 p.m. It's Sunday Bloody Sunday. In a Tennessee chain match for the Smoky Mountain title, Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch takes on the Dirty White Boy with Ron Wright in his corner. The Bullet puts it all on the line in a Texas death match against the turbulent Texan Terry Funk. Falls don't count. The match will continue until one man cannot answer the bell. If the Bullet wins, Bob Armstrong becomes commissioner again. But if Funk wins, the Bullet leaves Smoky Mountain Wrestling forever and must kiss Jim Cornette's feet. The Heavenly Bodies face Mike and Doug Furnace in the Tennessee-Alabama match. A UT football helmet will be on a 10-foot pole. The man who gets it can use it. If the Furnaces lose, they must wear Alabama sweatshirts in the ring. The Bruise Brothers return to face the Wild and Crazy Moondogs inside a steel cage. Tracy Smothers faces Chris Candido in a war between the Saints. And in a lights-out revenge match, the Rock and Roll Express face the Heavenly Bodies in a battle of family pride. Championship prices will apply for this super card. Ringside, $10. General admission, $8. And kids under 12, $6. If you see one wrestling card this year, it's got to be Sunday Bloody Sunday at the Civic Coliseum, Sunday, February 13th at 3 p.m.
Now you can have the Bluegrass Brawl, Smoky Mountain Wrestling's wildest event ever on home video. Witness the three-team street fight, the Heavenly Bodies against the Stud Stable, against the Rock and Roll Express and Arn Anderson. Relive the magic of Tracy Smothers winning the Smoky Mountain Wrestling title. All matches complete and uncut. Send for a free merchandise brochure with tapes, shirts, caps, photos, and more. Write to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37814. Order your merchandise today from Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling at your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, it's going to be a wild day. Sunday, Bloody Sunday in Knoxville on February 14th. These two right here are going to have a lot to do with it that day.
You know, I cannot believe this is actually happening. Not only do we have a chain match with the Dirty White Boy, but Ron Wright is coming back, and we crippled him, and he shouldn't be back, and it's just not fair. Brian's a wrestler. He should have a wrestling match, not one of these barbaric, stupid chain matches, and I'm going to get blood all over my clothes, and I don't know what to do because
blood? What are you... Clothes?
Yeah!
Tammy, that's my blood. I might get killed in this match. It's a chain match. What are you talking about? Your clothes? I can't. You're my manager. I can't even believe this is happening
that's
to me.
It's not my fault.
Well, whose fault is it?
It's
you're
not my fault.
I'll tell you what, Dirty White Boy, it's somebody's fault, and I'm going to put all the blame on you. I'm going to see by February 13th, I'm going to take you out, and you probably won't even make it to that date. Come on, Tammy. I can't believe this is going
it's
on.
Not my
Sunday, February 13th, fans. Right now, let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is set for one fall. Introducing from Hell's Kitchen, New York, at 305 pounds, Killer Kyle.
Okay, Bob, listen, wait a minute now.
Did you notice a little dissension in the household there?
Whoa.
What about that, Doug?
He was talking about blood on her clothes, and he said, blood on my clothes.
It's my blood.
It's my blood.
Yeah.
Man, it reminded me of a few arguments me and my old lady had.
All right. And the guy that may be drawing that blood is making his way to the ring right now.
Yeah, but see, my old lady talked like that. I straightened her out, man. He let her keep talking. He shouldn't have done that. Okay, let's hear the announcement from Brian Matthews.
And ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Bucksport, Tennessee, at 250 pounds, the Dirty White Boy.
There you see the Dirty White Boy standing in his ring with this now infamous Tennessee chain. Looking forward to February the 13th.
I'm looking forward to that, Dutch. You're talking about a change match, and you heard him say not going to the ring in a wheelchair, but Ron Wright is going to walk to the ring. He's going to be in that corner of the Dirty White Boy. He's going to walk down there. I tell you, and you heard the White Boy say there's not going to be a dry eye in the place.
Okay, fans, if you'd like a personal appearance by one of the Smoky Mountain Wrestling stars at your business, call Pam Lawson at 615-587-1273. For more information. All right, let's get back to the match right now. Yeah, Tammy Finch and Brian Lee, yeah, there was a lot of bitter dissension there. That's the first time we have heard that. Now, you gotta start thinking. Now she's showing up at the match with Chris Candido.
Yeah.
Now her and primetime Brian Lee are not quite seeing eye to eye. Now, usually these things happen in private.
Yeah.
But now they've aired some dirty laundry in public. Hey, man, I know people. I know women. I've been around women all my life.
Don't tell on yourself,
I've had thousands of women because they've all loved me.
Don't tell on yourself, Dutch.
Well, I have. But see, I knew how to handle all of them, and I knew when to get rid of them. So, but let's go to the match right now.
This is a real battle of the brutes, too, right here. The Dirty White Boy, he better treat Kyle with some care.
You see that move right there?
His chances in that Tennessee chain.
Did you see that move right there? The Dirty White Boy, he kicked him in the knee. That's one of the most devastating moves in wrestling, because when you take a guy's wheels out, I mean, you take him down. And he kicked him right in the side. Dirty White Boy, of course, moving right now, trying on
that leg muscle, and he is really working on it, Dutch.
Well, he has the, I hate to say this, but White Boy really hasn't changed his style at all. Some of the people like him a little bit right now, but he's still the same despicable person he's always been, and still wrestling the same way. But by the same token, you have to respect White Boy's attitude that he's got to do, like he's got to go home with the girl that brought him to the dance.
Yep.
This is what got him here. The style got him here, and he's going to stay with it.
Well, the fans, you can just feel the excitement as it begins to build, Dutch, about the 13th. And part of it, of course, is because the king of the chain matches, Ron Wright's going to walk to the ring and be in the Dirty White Boy's corner. What a match that's got to be when you talk about two big guys like the Dirty White Boy, primetime Brian Lee, with a chain in there, Dutch, and they can use that chain as a weapon. And as you heard Primetime Brian Lee say, blood's going to spill. There ain't any doubt in my mind it's going to.
Well, we've said this before, I'm going to say it again. They're not calling it Sunday, Bloody Sunday, for nothing. You got a cage match. You got the Dogs, the Bruise Brothers. You got the Furnace guys there. They may be wearing Alabama uniforms. Ricky Morton can't touch Jim Cornette outside a sanctioned SMW match. A lot of things going on in Smoky Mountain, and it's all going to culminate February the 13th, Knoxville Civic Coliseum.
Kyle just raked those fingernails right down across the back of the white boy. That big, powerful elbow smash right to the back of the head. He has really slowed the white boy down at this point. Sets him up for that big, powerful right hand. And that guy's got, he's got hands like pork chops. Big, huge hands on the big man, Killer Kyle.
Well, what you got here, you got two guys, both big, powerful men with the same style, and they're just hammering it out. You won't see any fireman's carries here. You won't see any suplexes. You're just going to see brute force against brute force.
Well, you heard Dutch a little earlier, fans, tell you about those personal appearances. And again, let me remind you, if you want a Smoky Mountain star, it's your business. Just call Pam Lawson, 615-587-1273. Well, I think I did it better than you did.
Oh, I don't think so. I guess you thought the people didn't hear me when I did it. You got to. Okay, Bob, thank you very much. Now you've embarrassed me on the air. I've already done it one time, and you had to go and do it again. You want me to do it again? I'll do it again.
I think that's the
fans, thing. If you want a Smoky Mountain Wrestling star and appears your business, call Pam Lawson at 615-587-1273. I did it the best, not you.
Right back
to the match now. Killer
Kyle. White boy's reeling, too.
He should be reeling.
He's held
He's
up
really
going
to be reeling on February the 13th. See, Bob, you've got me pumped up now. You've embarrassed me already by saying I didn't talk about the personal appearances well enough. But right now, Killer Kyle.
I've got him covered, Dutch. Two.
He
almost had him for three.
Referee Mark Curtis almost went down for a three count, didn't he? Wait a minute, cradle back. White boy may have him. One, two, no.
A count of two that time on Kyle. And look at Kyle, that tremendous clothesline, that big arm of his.
You know, one thing you got to...
Only a count of two again.
You got to admire that little referee who probably weighs a buck 40 in there. In the ring with these 300 pounders and 200...
Is that dripping wet?
Dripping wet.
Yep.
He's in there, and if he gets touched, if he gets hurt, I'm going to tell you, it wouldn't take much to hurt him because he's not a very big guy. But he's in there, and I'll say one thing. He does a fairly credible job as far as referees. I don't like referees to start off with anyway.
Well, you see, now the white boy going back to that leg.
Well,
he had him hopping around on that leg earlier in the match, Dutch. Now he's returned to that. Well, going upstairs now to the head.
Yeah, he went back to an area that was hurt on Killer Kyle. Now white boy up on the outside. Kyle better
just
turn.
Just get a buck snort blaster.
A crossbody. One, two.
No, wait a minute. Here comes prime time. There's Brian Lee.
Oh! I think white boy was waiting on him. And now to Kyle. Back to Kyle.
Right hand to right hand. Kyle goes down. Lee goes down.
And he's doing it.
The bell's trying to get him out of the ring. It says it's all over. Let's stop this.
Wait a minute.
Referee completely helpless in there.
Tammy Fitz has nailed white girl on the other side. On the outside, I don't know if we can see that. Here comes Candido.
Well, he's got the key. He's got Killer Kyle's violin case to the back of the Dirty White Boy.
Now it's three against one. It looks like the Dirty White Girl, I can't see her anywhere.
I think she's...
I think she's on the
far... Last I saw her, she was on the apron. I think she may be down on the floor now. Yeah.
Okay, Brian Lee up on the outside.
There she is, still on the apron. Here's Lee now, up on that top rope, Dutch.
They got the White Boy stretched out. Wait a minute.
Tracy Smothers.
Here he comes. Oh!
Smothers now going to get hit from behind.
Now here comes Kyle and Candido trying to take out Tracy Smothers.
The white boy's gone to the corner, Dutch. Watch out. He's got that chain. He's going to clear house now.
And everybody's getting out of the ring. Wait a minute. There's one man left.
Brian Lee.
He's got Lee.
He's got it around
his neck. He's got him hung. He's got it around his neck. And over the top, and he's got him hung.
He's got him hung over on the rope, Dutch.
And it's pure Penna. They're trying to get him loose. They're trying
to
get him.
White boy and Tracy Smothers, they're trying to keep him from getting him loose. They finally got him loose. They saved him. I think what would be just in the nick of time, fans. We got to go. We'll be back right after this.
White boy coming after him.
Wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming to Red Jacket, West Virginia. Red Jacket Grade School Gym, Friday, February 18th, 8 p.m. with five big matches in Red Jacket. West Liberty, Kentucky, Morgan County High School, Saturday, February 12th, 8 p.m., two title bouts and a battle royal in West Liberty. Appalachia, Virginia at the Civic Center, Friday, February 4th, 8 p.m., the Rock and Roll Express, the Dirty White Boy, and more. And Heartland, Kentucky's Kaywood High School, we're coming back Friday, February the 11th, 8 p.m. Tracy Smothers against the Suicide Blonde Chris Candido for the U.S. Junior Heavyweight title. Also a grudge tag match, the Bruise Brothers against the Moondogs, and it's a Smoky Mountain street fight, the Dirty White Boy with the White Girl against Brian Lee and Tammy Fitch.
When is this going to end, White Boy? What are you going to do? Petition for your kind of matches, match after match after match, until you win? This time it's a street fight. Brian's a wrestler. He's not a street fighter. What? This is professional wrestling. This isn't professional street fighting. Get it straight. I mean, please, go to school, learn what wrestling is, and then maybe we won't have to have these ridiculous, stupid matches anymore. And, of course, he's probably going to have his little walking infection, the Dirty White Girl there. You know, one difference, huge difference, between myself and the Dirty White Girl. I'm a 9-to-5 career woman. Well, she's just like 7-Eleven, open all night, if you know what I mean.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling in Harlan, Kentucky, Kaywood High School for the tag titles. Two out of three falls, the Heavenly Bodies against the Rock and Roll Express.
You know, just like it says, wrestling the way it used to be, and that's the way it used to be. Two out of three falls. Now, the Rock and Roll Express, they're upset about what happened last. They're upset about not winning the belts. They say they've been cheated. They say they want to get revenge. Say, Paul Morton sent it home wanting Ricky to get his hands around my neck. So it's a two out of three fall match. It's for the title, and Ricky Morton's going to have one eye on me at all times. Well, I got news for you, brother. The Rock and Roll say that nobody can beat them twice in one night. Well, they can't beat the Bodies twice in one night either. So where does that leave us? In Harlan, Kentucky, it leaves us with a hell of a fight. Friday night, February 11th at that Kaywood High School, two out of three, Bodies and Rock and Roll.
Hotel accommodations for Smoky Mountain Wrestling were provided by the Holiday Inn Express in Abingdon, Virginia, where you will find clean, affordable smoking or non-smoking rooms, on-site laundry facilities, pool, and a complimentary deluxe continental breakfast. Or if you need the perfect ending for a romantic evening, consider their jacuzzi suites. Holiday Inn Express, Abingdon, recipient of the 1993 Holiday Inn Worldwide Quality Excellence Award. Exit 19 in Abingdon, Virginia, right off I-81.
Fans, unbelievable wild time in the ring there. Tracy's mother, Dirty White Boy, Dirty White Girl, White Girl.
Here, listen up here, you little street walking tramp. When I get my hands on you, honey, I promise you there's going to be hell to pay.
Tracy.
Hey, White Boy, as bad as you and I hate each other, I think we both hate that backstabbing Brian and that crybaby Chris and that stinking Tammy Witch worse.
You better believe it.
Hey, I say let's take care of these guys. You got a partner you can trust right here. I give you my word again as a man. Let's kick those guys' butts once and for all.
You got it, big guy.
And what I'm looking forward to, February the 13th, Knoxville, Tennessee, at the Coliseum. It's a chain match.
There you go.
And Ron Wright is going to walk that aisle with me. A man, a living legend that has never, ever lost a chain match. So there's no way in hell, primetime, I'm going to lose in front of Ron Wright. What you just got out here was just a small, small taste of what's going to happen on the 13th in K-Town. Because then, big boy, in Knoxville Coliseum, I'm going to hang you with this chain from the damn rafters. And as God is my witness, I'm walking out the Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Champion.
All right, fans, it's going to be Sunday, Bloody Sunday, Knoxville, Tennessee, February 13th. You don't want to miss that. Next week, right here, Ron Wright. Much more. We'll see you then. And until then, so long for now.